AT&T calls for the removal of the OAS Secretary General. And in sport, the West Indies Cricket Board officially renamed. I'm Ricardo Roberts, and this is Caribbean in 10 for Thursday, June 1st. I'll be back with the details after the break. Trinidad and Tobago has called for the removal of Secretary General of the Organization of American States, Luis Almagro, over his non-neutral position on the political situation in Venezuela. Now, speaking to the media yesterday evening on his return from an official two-day visit to Chile, Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley said the Twin Island Republic had registered strong objection to Almagro's behavior because of the very derogatory manner in which he had engaged Venezuela's President Nicolas Maduro. Almagro has called for the suspension of Venezuela from the Washington-based group unless general elections are held soon to break a political impasse that he said is destroying the country's democracy. He has been under fire from Venezuela and several other countries for his stance. Rowley said Almagro's job requires him not to take sides, and because he has shown partisanship, the OAS is compromised and cannot now play any significant role in treating with Venezuela's difficulty. And the Trinidadian leader warned that if CARICOM is not careful, it could, quote, destroy itself as an honest broker with respect to any involvement in assistance to Venezuela and its internal problems, end quote. The St. Kitts and Nevis government has confirmed that a Chinese national wanted by the international police, Interpol, is assisting local police in their investigations. Prime Minister Dr. Timothy Harris made the disclosure at a wide-ranging press conference yesterday, even as he said he would have preferred police to make a statement on the matter. It was revealed earlier this year that Chinese national Ren Bio and his family were living in the Twin Island Federation, although he was wanted in his home country on charges of swindling a Chinese state firm out of more than $100 million. The government has been accused of harboring the Chinese national who obtained citizenship under the Denzel Douglas administration through the country's Citizenship by Investment program. Harris said local police are handling the matter.
I had reported that this was an active investigation, and on matters of active investigation, it's not prudent policy to comment on it. I could, however, say that I am advised that the personalities of interest, they have been with the police, and I wouldn't want to say more.
And while he revealed little about the ongoing investigation, Prime Minister Harris had a lot to say about the opposition St. Kitts Nevis Labour Party using the issue to score political points. He accused opposition members of spreading false information. Caribbean countries that have been struggling with lower than normal rainfall can expect some relief this hurricane season, which begins today. Forecasters are predicting above normal activity in the June 1st to November 30th season. Regional forecasters, disaster managers, and other officials are meeting in Kingstown for the annual wet hurricane season Caribbean Climate Outlook Forum. Yesterday, Dr. Cedric Van Merbeek, climatologist at the Caribbean Institute for Meteorology and Hydrology, told CMC what the projections are for this hurricane season.
National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, which now predicts a likelihood of 11 to 17 named storms, so that's tropical storms or worse, out of which there would be between 4 and 7 or even more possibly hurricanes and up to three, I believe, severe hurricanes or major hurricanes, category 3, 4, or 5, throughout the entire Atlantic basin. That doesn't mean that we're going to get all of them coming through the Caribbean, and it doesn't even mean that we're certain that those ranges are correct. When you hear such a range, it's telling you we are about 70% certain that it will be between that minimum and that maximum, so between 11 and 17 named storms.
Stay with us. Your midday sport is next. Welcome back. It's now time for sport. The West Indies Cricket Board yesterday formally announced the much-anticipated name change to Cricket West Indies, saying the rebranding accurately represents the function of the governing body. President Dave Cameron had announced the move 2 years ago and last January said the process had been completed. He said the new name is more inclusive and is a key part of the new way forward in the board's enhancement of its governance. In addition to the name change, the board also launched their rebranded website, as well as announcing that all representative teams will be referred to as the Windies. The name change for the board is the second in the last 21 years following the decision by another Jamaican WICB president, Pat Russo, to drop control from the original name. It also comes just under 2 years after a governance review panel commissioned by Regional National Group in CARICOM recommended the immediate dissolution of the WICB and the installment of an interim board. The panel chaired by UWE Cavehill Professor Eudine Barito slammed the board as a now proven obsolete governance framework. In Bermuda now, the America Cup qualifiers were called off yesterday because winds in the Great Sound were below the 6 knots needed for racing. Organizers say the day's 4 races will now be held today, which had initially been a scheduled rest day in the month-long tournament. Oracle Team USA, the defending champions who are guaranteed a place in the final, lead the qualifiers with 6 points, one ahead of Emirates Team New Zealand, with Britain's Land Rover Bar third on 4. Sweden's Artemis Racing Groupama Team France and SoftBank Team Japan share bottom spot on 2 points apiece. Now the team finishing last will be eliminated before the start of the America's Cup Challenger playoffs semifinals on Sunday. That's Caribbean in 10. Join us again later this evening at 6:30 for Caribbean Newsline. Good afternoon.